Hi guys, and welcome to another WonderHero video. So in this video, I'll be talking about the just released PvP, the player versus player, or the so-called the competitive mode in WonderHero. It's actually a revamped version of the existing PvP mode from the Steam version of the game, which is Battlestar. So it is somewhat modified, so they did some work on it to modify the layout as well as how it plays. But overall, it's the auto battler style from the Steam game coming along to the WonderHero NFT game is still the same. So we'll probably just introduce the layout here. So when you are at the menu screen here, if you click on PvP, there is a basic requirement that your player level, which is on the top left here, if you click on this avatar portrait, your player level here needs to be at least level 6. So your account has to be, you know, been playing for a significant period of time. Generally, I think to reach level 6, you need to play about approximately 2 to 3 weeks, I think. At least 3 weeks to be safe to reach level 6. And the further chapters you go, the more EXP you gain towards the player level. So obviously, the better team you have, the faster you will level up your player level. Because the better team that you have, the further you can go in the chapters, right? So you can level up your player level faster, and then you can reach PvP faster. Currently, the rewards, if we look at the WonderHero Discord, so let's look at the WonderHero Discord here. If you look at the announcements, yep, so they disable Infinite War for now. I think there should be an announcement here. So if you go to the WonderHero Discord, which you can go to, so I'm going to show you how to get to the WonderHero Discord again. So go to WonderHero website, wonderhero.io, right? And if you from their homepage, scroll all the way down under their socials, there's a link for their Discord right here, right? Discord right here at the bottom right hand corner, right? Okay, so anyway, back to their Discord. So if you look at their Discord under announcements, when they announced PvP, that was on February 27. So as of recording, it's 2 days ago. Then if you click on that link provided, they will have a so-called their medium.com announcement. So right now, you can see that they feature up to 5 ranks. But right now, the only rank that they allow us to level up for this first week is just Black Iron. So I think how it works is that if you get top 50 in your Black Iron group, you will progress into the Silver group on the following week. Then you can see the announcement here, starting from Black Iron, 30 players randomly group, top 50% promoted to Silver, the rest will stay in Black Iron. Then from Silver, there you can see how the progression goes from, I think, Silver here, the announcement. Top 30% will go into gold, top 20% will go into diamond, and then top 20% of diamond will go into legendary, and so on and so forth. But for this first week, it's so the PvP is going to be a long-term thing, which I think is good for the game. That means they're not, you know, so people won't like just climb to the top and then quit the game. So it's going to take a while for the ranks to be released. I'm guessing based on this development, they probably might release a rank every week. Like maybe next week they release Silver, the week after that Gold, and the week after that Diamond, and then finally 1 month later they'll release Legendary. So that's what I think that their plan is, so that people, you know, there's more time for people to climb the PvP ladder and so on and so forth. Their ranking rewards, so WND, so you can see here among the rewards here, WND plus Lottery. I don't know why there's only one lottery for the higher ranks. I think there's more WND in the higher ranks as well. But in my opinion, there should be more lotteries for the higher ranks to give it a better reward per se. But then again, because the WonderHero market is a little bit flooded at the moment with item and hero skin prices and weapon prices being super cheap, like they're all going to the floor. So maybe the developers were thinking that they don't want to give too many items or too many lotteries out in case their market gets even oversaturated with items. So right now, obviously, the WonderHero team is trying to attract new players to get more demand for the items. So if new players come in, they buy up the items, and then that will be a little bit, they'll push up the floor price of the items, and the more people can sell their stuff, their equipment, and they can earn from selling. Okay, so lottery rewards can win weapon, hero skin. So basically, it's your weekly item box. I think it's very similar to the item box that you get from the weekly quest, which is this box from completing the weekly quest, where you can get one hero skin or one weapon. Then you can win up to 50 horn, 50 WND or 300 horn. So 50 WND is not a bad price at all, because WND price has been somewhat stable. Like the lowest I've seen it was I think down to 80 cents or 90 cents, but today it's jumped up to $1. So it's not too bad. Obviously, horn price has been dropping because it's the main utility token, and more people are getting more horn compared to WND, but WND seems to be stable, somewhat stable, which is a good sign. And let's go on and see the lottery rules. So basically, okay, so there's a lottery page on the home page itself. It's not here yet, so I'm thinking they'll probably include it, because this looks to be their testnet. Wonder Hero PvP Wonder Box. So Wonder Box Play U System. Yeah, so it's gonna come in between the PvP, the Wonder Box, as well as the Play tabs. So it's gonna come in between here. Currently, as of today, which is the 1st of March, looking at the website, it has not updated this tabs yet. So probably they will update it by the end of the week, I presume, to have a lottery tab. So if you're eligible for a lottery when you log in, let's say you've completed your PvP for that week, eligible for a lottery, and then you can go to that page and draw this. So the lottery will go, I think, round and round. Oh my god, that's a zero for lottery? Oh, this is bad, man. I think the game developers should remove this, because it'll be super bad if you go to a lottery and you don't win anything. Even winning 50 horn is like feels bad, man. Oh my god. So the lottery is it's really lottery. Wow, that's not that good. Okay, so lottery chances will be cancelled. Okay, so how to claim your prizes? So once you claim the lottery, then you can eligible PvP leaderboard. So you can visit the PvP leaderboard, which is you click on the PvP leaderboard tab and then claim your prize. How to play? So it says here players need to be account level 6 and at least 4 playable heroes. So this is different from the starting requirements for PvE, right? So obviously, when Wonder Hero first released, when they launched, they say you just need one single hero and one weapon skin to play. Then people have been getting away with that. And then they find that they needed to increase the demand for the items in the marketplace. Then they increased it to 3 playable heroes under PvE. But now they find that their market is still being flooded with more and more items, which are getting cheaper and cheaper by the day, by the hour, actually, because there's not enough players coming in to buy these items off. Not enough like guilds to buy items for the scholarships and stuff like that. So I think they are increasing it to 4 playable heroes, which is also fair. I can't say it's really fair or not, because the idea is there are certain players which are able to spec up one single hero to be so OP that they can clear like chapter 10 with like one single hero. So it is possible to get one single hero to be really, really strong and really OP. But yeah, I mean, this is what the developers have decided, that they want to increase the demand for their hero skins as well as weapons in the market. So they are promoting the basic requirements from 3 playable heroes up to 4 playable heroes in order for the player to start participating in PvP. Each day you get 5 PvP chances. So this 5 PvP chances, I think, is 5 attack chances, which I'll explain later. Then you gain points if you win, lesser points if you lose. If you're a win streak, you gain bonus, and so on and so forth. Then you go up the rank in the leaderboard. 2 main components is defense team lineup. Okay, I'll show that later. Then basically a defense team lineup is what other players will play against. So the good thing about PvP is that it's not real time, it's an auto battler. That means you can just start PvP and then you can go have your tea, have your lunch, and then come back when the PvP match is done and then go for the next PvP. You don't even need to watch it, right? And then on the defense, it's like while you're not playing, people are playing against your defense team. So if they beat your defense team, they gain more points. If they lose against your defense team, you gain more points. I think that's quite simple. And this strategy of so-called PvP arena has been around for many years among the mobile game genre, especially the mobile RPG genre, mobile turn-based RPG genre, because I've played this kind of PvP before on other mobile games, whereby you just put up your team and then other players will play against your team while you're offline, and it's all auto-battler, so you don't really control anything. So you don't get advantage from being there live, right? You don't need to commit time to it. Attack team lineup is basically similar, you just win the attack team lineup. Okay, so going back into the game, let's go to PvP. I'll just demonstrate in-game here. So basically, when you click on any of the heroes here, if you see any of the heroes, you click on this, you will get into the team, so-called the team management, where you can remove your heroes, like remove the heroes and you click back. Okay, it's still there. So this team has been locked in, I think. So if you want, you need to rearrange the team. So I put it this way and I press back. It is still the same though. Okay. But anyway, once you have your four heroes selected, if you save as defense, then you say whether you save your current settings as the arena defense line, click confirm. So this team that you just selected will be saved as the defense team. If you want it to like go into attack with a different team, so let's say I want to like have my Cersei in here, right? Cersei. And I put my Helen as well as my Muramasa, Shion Muramasa, and this, and then I back it up. Okay, so it takes a while. So now this is my offense team. And then you can see my defense team has not changed. So my previous team that I've saved here is the defense team, which is still there. And then this is now my offense team. So if you click join arena, you will go into a match. But I wanted to also highlight that right now, I think most of the groups that you're grouped with might be bots as well. So you can look at the leaderboard here at the bottom left, and then you will see that, yes, I'm currently first, but I think all the other so-called players in my so-called my group or my lobby are actually bots, because if you look at their names, they're very generic names, right? With like generic names, there is no typo error, there is no like numbers mixed with names, there's no underscore, there's no numerics, like mine, I call myself Fate 25, right? There's numeric, because you need to have numeric, I think, to be unique. If I just put Fate, I don't think it's accepted, because probably somebody already took that name. But if you look at the all these names are like all generically, there's commas, there's correct punctuation, there's no spelling mistakes. So all this looks like all they are like auto AI generated names. And level 5, level 9, I'm not sure. Okay, this is the player level. So this is another hint that these are all bots as well. You can see that all of these are exactly at player level 5, which is not correct as well, because according to the WonderHero announcement, right, you need to be player level 6, you know, account need to be level 6 in order to play. But it says here this account are at player level 5. My account is at player level 9, which is correct. If you look at, go to main menu, click on this, you see I'm level 9, right, player info. So this is correct, so mine is correct, but the rest of the leaderboard, so called the lobby or the group, are seemingly all bots, right? And I'll show that why they're all bots as well, because all their so-called their characters are also at like a fixed level. They are at level 40, no higher, no lower. And let's go back to the arena screen and let's click join arena. So let's play against, you know, so-called one of these bots, and you will see why. First thing you notice on the bottom right, they are all one star skins. So if you've played WonderHero at all, you know that it's not possible to have a one-star skin, because once you buy a hero skin, right, in the marketplace, the minimum is 3 stars. Once you equip that, as well as you equip a weapon on it, your minimum hero will be 3 stars, as shown in the team lineup area. So it's not possible for the heroes to be 1 star. So the only way it will be 1 star is that these are like non-player characters that they actually just program, you know, program bots. They're non-player characters, that's why they're 1 star. Because they don't actually have the actual skin or the actual weapons. And you can see that all of the characters are actually at level 40. If you look at the, pay attention to the top right hand corner, all of the opponents are all at level 40. So if you're a real player, it's actually not possible for you to be, you know, to have all your heroes like fixed at level 40. It's not possible. You see, all are 1 star. Under this is love on the bottom right. So it's proof that they are bots. And then let's look at, put your attention on the top right hand corner. If you look at the top right hand corner, all of their characters are all exactly level 40, which is like not possible in a real game, right? So in the real team, it's not possible. You have your team which are like maybe level, some are like level 20, level 30, and then the others are level 60 or level 50, because most of the time you'll want to buff your core DPS or your highest, your highest damage dealing DPS the most. And then the other support characters, maybe you don't need to buff them as much, so you're not going to spend as much wisdom pots on them. So then, so it's never going to be a situation where all your team members are directly at level 40. So why are there bots in the lobbies or the group? My guess is that because this is the first week that they're launching PvP on WonderHero, my guess is that they are just filling up with bots to make it, you know, something like a test to see whether the arena mode, the PvP, will go on smoothly or not. Like, whether there's any hiccups or not while bots are running. So, also is to make it, I guess, easier for players to promote. So that all the legit players here, as long as you're not a team that's under level 40, you probably are going to win. You're probably going to be top 50% of your group, and then you're probably going to go on to silver. So all the legit players who play PvP this week are probably going to go above Black Iron, above into Silver, and my guess is that I'm not too sure on whether week 2, whether will the lobbies still fill up with bots, or will we actually be matched up with all the players who actually promoted into Silver. Because assuming that no, all players are playing against bots, and assuming all the players win against the bots, right, because all of them will get like top first or second rank in their lobby, right, and then they will promote into silver, because top 50% go to silver. So hopefully by next week, week 2 of PvP, we will be matching against real players, all promoted into the silver lobby, but I'm not too sure, because I'm thinking that maybe in the silver lobbies, they might still put some players, and then the rest, fill up the rest with bots. Because first and foremost, maybe they are afraid that there's not enough player base in WonderHero to fill up all the PvP groups with players. That could be one concern, but I'm more thinking along the lines that they're probably trying to test out the stability of the PvP service and so on. So that's why they're filling up with bots for now. Because the thing about bots is that bots also don't invade as well, right? Because you have a defense team. So the real players will play against your defense team, but if it's bots, I don't think the bots will play against your defense team at all. So if they don't play against your defense team, you're not getting any points from participating in defense, which is technically unlimited, right? Because if you just put your defense team there and you don't play, technically the opponent players can keep playing against your defense team and you can gain points, unlimited points through that. So having bot lobbies doesn't really help the defense team points. So, I'm not too sure how I feel about this, but I mean, it is what it is. Currently, it is already, the system is already there. So you can see that winning is really easy, because most of my team is obviously at level 70. I think my characters are at level 70 plus, and then the bots are at level 40. So there's like almost double the level difference, as well as the equipment. That you can see the damage that my characters do is in the thousands, whereby they're doing less than hundreds. So this is very obvious to be a cakewalk for me, right? Like, you're not even doing 100 damage against me because of my resist values. My resist for my heroes, my resist values are about, you know, 200 range. So they're probably, these bots are probably doing in the range of like maybe 200 attack to 300 attack, 300 damage per attack, which we can't really see their stats because we cannot pause the game, right? You can see that this is an auto battler. I cannot disable the auto. I can slow it down, so I can slow it down to 1x speed. But I cannot click on the magnifier plus icon on the bottom left of my heroes as well as the top right of the enemies. So I cannot look at their stats, I cannot see their attack and so on. So yeah, so we can't see the stats of these bots, but I'm guessing based on the damage numbers that they do, they're probably in like maybe doing 200 to 300 damage. So you can see all the bots have basic 3-star skins as well as 3-star weapons. And it should be easy to clear this. Okay, so I think that's it, right? Do I have more? Yeah. So I finished all my 5 arenas. And finished all my 5 arena challenges. And you can see that the ranking stays first, obviously, because it's 10 wins and then there's points. Weekly prize is released here if one lottery draw, which I don't really like the lottery system because there's a chance you get nothing and a chance you get very little horn in the BND. It's very random. I don't like, players don't really like the RNG of this aspect because especially when you have spent like real effort to climb this ladder and then you get an RNG reward that doesn't feel good and there's a chance you get nothing for all the effort. So that's the lottery is not good at all. I would rather they give like a fixed price. Like my criticism with this is that I would rather like if you go higher, like silver, gold, and diamond and legendary, you get guaranteed amounts of horn and WND, as well as like maybe a guaranteed amount of item loot boxes. Like maybe in the higher ranks you can like guarantee them at least one weapon box or one wonder box. Like maybe in the top ranks, one legendary, you can guarantee them one wonder box or something, which wonder box will contain both hero skin, a weapon, as well as the equipment. And then maybe in the lower ranks, you can at least guarantee them an equipment box or an item box, like the weekly reward box, that will give like one skin or one hero skin or one weapon, right? So that at least it feels better for the player to participate in PvP, because right now there is a chance that people do well in the PvP ranking at the end of the week because of the lottery system, they get nothing, which is not good at all. Yeah, so anything else that I can highlight in this arena system, which is obviously I show you the leaderboard. There's a friend ranking, which among your friend lists, you can click on the friend list and then you can see how your friends are doing. So obviously this Pekyo-san is a Japanese player, which is very, very OP. I've highlighted his YouTube in one of my earlier videos. Really, really OP. I think he has completed all 13 chapters. He's completed all 13 chapters in like the second week or something. He spent a lot on the game. So I think he's still holding on to many of his items. Hopefully he has sold some of it while the price was high, so that he can claw back some of his investment, but I'm not too sure. But looking at the strength of his team, I think he has kept most of his OP items. Then here you have a better record as well. And you can see the so-called latest 100 battle records. I think this is cool. The battle record system is cool. So you can see the amount of points you gain against certain teams. Like certain teams seems like you gain more points. And like certain right now, as we're going on a win streak, we're gaining more points, definitely. But even as we're gaining more points, you can see that this fourth win is 117, and this fifth win is only 98. And then this sixth win is 140, but the seventh win is 138, and the eighth win is only 124. And then 135 is still not the same as 140. But the last win here, we get 151. So I'm not too sure how this point system is calculated. But the details are quite cool, though. If you click on the details, you can actually see how much damage your heroes deal. Like you can see that my Helen at level 70 here actually dealt the bulk of the damage, almost 60% of the whole damage of my team. Yeah, a little lag there loading. So like 22k damage because of her range as well. Because of her range, she has a very wide range of attack. And she's a ranged hero as well, so she's hitting the enemies from further away. She's hitting a whole group of enemies further away, and she has abilities which have like double hits and triple hits. So this is why her damage output is the highest. And even though Shion Muramasa is my highest, so-called my highest damage, I have the highest damage in terms of stats, but because she's a melee hero, she can only damage the enemies surrounding her. So she actually doesn't hit that many enemies. And she's at level 81, but she only dealt like 16% of team damage. Even my Ling actually deals 21% of the damage because she has her ultimate, which is an AoE. She's a healer, but her ultimate is an AoE skill, and her ultimate actually dealt 8,000 plus damage. You can see how much she healed as well. So she healed 7,000 damage, which is pretty cool. But you can see heal stats under restore. Absorb is actually the shields. So how much damage has your shields absorbed? So there are certain heroes with certain passives that can regenerate shield. I think Fran is one of them. I'm not too sure on the other heroes, but I think there are certain items which give shield generation. So this stat is useful. Damage is self-explanatory. So how much damage the hero dealt? I think damage and total, I'm not too sure why there's a difference between damage and total. This doesn't make sense. Like the damage here is 22745, but the total is higher. So I'm not too sure on the difference between damage and total here. I'm thinking total. Whereas if you look at Ling here, right? She doesn't do any damage with her weapon because her weapon heals, but she has damage numbers under total because it's dealt by her ultimate. So I'm thinking the total here would involve damage dealt by ultimate, and the damage column is only the damage dealt by them using the weapon, which is It also doesn't make sense on the bot side here. If you look at the right side of the bots here, all their damage is under total, and you don't see anything under damage. You see very little under damage. But you can see a lot of numbers under total. Absorb, and their absorb stats are bugged as well. Their absorb stats are like so high, 8,000 plus. Is it all shield? Oh, okay. So absorb is not just shield. Absorb is also the damage taken by the hit points. Because they are all at because all the characters are actually buffed, they're having their hit points buffed when they're in the arena. So like in PvE, your heroes will be like 2,000, like maybe 1,000 plus to 2,000 hit points, right? Maximum you have is maybe a 4,000 hit point hero. But you realize when you go into arena, all of their hit points are buffed, like to 8k for Sigrid's bot, 7,000 for Valkyrie's bot, Ling has like 7,000, and then even Helen, one of the lowest, one of the DPS heroes with the lowest hit point stats, also has 5,000. So this absorb stat is actually the damage taken by the hit points as well as their heals. The damage is the amount of damage they dealt actually. So they deal very little damage against my heroes because my heroes have higher resist and defense values. The total here doesn't make sense, right? Yeah, this one doesn't make sense. It confuses me. But anyway, I'm saying that this stat is cool. So maybe once they fully explain how this works, or maybe they like debug it a bit between the total and the damage, because here it still seems weird, because I don't think my Shion cast any ultimate during that match, and I don't think my Helen cast any ultimate that during the match, but the damage numbers and the total numbers actually don't match up. So it is kind of wonky now for this, but I like, this is cool because I like the fact that you can actually see the contribution from your team members as well as your opponent's team members, so you can once this works well, right, this can actually show you like what's the meta, like what's the highest damage dealing heroes in the PvP based on the stats, right? Because stats technically never lie because they are all data, so as long as the stats are correctly collected. So the disclaimer is that the stats can be collected incorrectly by the program or by the game. So if it's incorrect, then yeah, then it's not precise. But if it's collected correctly, stats never lie, right? Because they're all actual data that is from stuff that has already happened in real life, happened in the match. So this shows you like, it will show you the meta of PvP by looking at the screen here. So you can see that obviously, probably in the PvP meta, I mean, right now, because we're all versus against bots, right now, like having a ranged hero is actually a good idea, right? Like in each and every single match, my Helen is the highest damage dealer of the whole team with 60% of the damage dealt, because she does damage in a big range. And yeah, compared to the melee heroes. So the melee heroes are actually not bad in PvE, because I mentioned in my earlier guides, the melee heroes have certain like execution skills, they have certain high damage numbers, they have good defense stats and so on. So they might be good in PvE, but if we're looking at it, actually maybe ranged heroes might be better in PvP. Especially for a Helen, like if you own a Helen and at least her 4-star weapon, maybe it might be really, really good in PvP. I'm not super sure, but obviously, well, the meta will only develop through time, right? So we have to go against real life players before we can see like what's the real damage numbers or the real contribution numbers per se under the details tab of the board. But I really like this. I really, really like the leaderboard. I really like the details part of it. Not the leaderboard. I really like the battle record. The battle record and the details part of the battle record. It's really cool. I love that they display this data. And all this data will only help players to get more solid information about their team lineups, about their opponent team lineups, and to know the meta. And when you develop a meta, obviously those heroes, equipments, as well as skins in the marketplace will sell for a higher price, because they are probably in higher demand, right, for people who want to climb up against PvP. So now, right now, my only gripe against PvP is that I think the rewards should be better, because if the rewards are just a random lottery at the end of the week, and if you look at the lottery page here, there's a chance that you get nothing, a set face, and then you a chance that you only get like 50 horn, which is way less than like what most people will get in PvE. This is for the whole week, mind you. So yeah, this rewards really look lackluster. So my only gripe now is with the rewards. And obviously the bot lobbies as well, if they are pitting, I would prefer that they put us against real players in the real groups and real lobbies as soon as possible. So that, yeah, it's more exciting, because, I mean, even though it's easy to win against bots, but, you know, it's not fun, right? Because the point of PvP is player versus player, right? It's not PvE, it's not player versus, I don't even know what E means, right? It's not player versus bots, right? So the whole idea is PvP, player versus players, right? So you want to play against other players. So if not, then what's the point of PvP? Playing against bots. So okay, that's it for my long-winded rant. Hope this helps anyone who is starting into arenas, or who is new into the game, who is interested on how arena looks like. And we'll see you guys on the next video. Thank you.